Strawberry Switchblade. And more esoteric offerings from the Blue Nile. But that was pretty much it for the rest of the century. Then, in 2012, a new kind of synthpop band exploded onto the scene. They embraced traditional technology, but produced decidedly modern music. Churches.
I heard that and immediately I said, I love that. Faster, faster, you won't go far. Shouldn't leave, feeling faint, we both know why. You've got to show me, both knees, call out alive. Churches are three people who played in indie and alternative bands in the Glasgow scene. But they were obviously huge pop lovers. Ian and Doc, the production side of it, had started experimenting with synths. And then when they met up with Lauren, I think the magic was just there.
It's almost mathematical precision pop, where everything in that song is geared towards making it an enriching, exciting, and joyful listen. I can feel your dirt in mine. That's what pop music should be.
And what a sound. But I think their sounds are kind of old-fashioned sounds. You know, they sound like late 70s, early 80s sounds to me. And I think that's what makes it good. Because they're using kind of, it sounds to me like analog synths.
I think there's something modern about churches because the constant fluctuation and forward movement of electronic music. The software that you're recording on, the kind of synth sounds and so on are always improving. They've taken those modern production values and combined it perhaps with their love of 80s electronica and synth pop.
I saw them live a couple of years ago and I loved it. And yeah, I think they're very unique and I think they're very original, but I can sort of hear the influences as well. But I think 80s music influences lots of bands. I think I do hear a little bit of Altered Images influence in, and it always makes me feel good.
I think churches are for sure leading Scotland with pop music at the moment. There's no doubt about it. I mean, you don't have top 10 albums in 20, 30 countries across the world unless you're doing something right. So I see them as a very modern Scottish pop band, but also a very modern global pop band.
Pop music has always evolved with the introduction of new technology. But the creation of the synthesizer incited one of the most striking and crucial changes in musical history. It turned punk bands into new wave futurists, made stars out of reclusive geniuses, shone a light on gender and sexual politics at a time when they were very far from the mainstream agenda, and has given the world another pure pop Scottish success story that's only just beginning. So here's to the synth and all the pop it has given us.